At a recent ceremony at the Chinese Academy of Sciences, Cornell University President David Skorton hands over the collection of 70-year-old fungi that had been meticulously gathered by scholar Xu Chun Teng.
So I think the most important part of what we're doing here today is really returning a hand to the Chinese people that was outstretched three quarters of a century ago.
Commemorating the return of the former Cornell student's extensive collection, Skorton presents a wooden box with one of Teng's original envelopes and typewritten labels. Teng studied mycology at Cornell University in the 1920s, then spent the next decade traveling on horseback, gathering molds, lichens, yeasts, rusts, and morels in the forests, fields, and marshes of his homeland. During the Japanese invasion in 1937, Teng arranged for his best specimens to be removed from the National Botany Institute he directed to save them from destruction. But that action meant Teng became a target during the devastating 1966-76 Cultural Revolution. Discharged from his lab, Teng was subjected to daily beatings and mental persecution that ruined his health and career. He died in 1970 at the age of 67. Teng's daughter Deng Yi said she thinks her father would be happy to see the mushrooms returned to China. At Cornell's initiative, the university divided up and is sharing its fungi of China collection with the Academy's Institute of Microbiology.